What's the difference between standard events, and custom conversions? Well, that's what we're diving into today in this episode of Online Confidential, where I take you behind the scenes to talk about secret ad manager business. Now, if you're running ads for clients, chances are you've heard about each of these: standard events, custom conversions, but perhaps you haven't heard about custom events. I've got people who have joined the Elite Ad Manager certification who have run ads for some time, but hadn't heard of custom events. And this was a whole new thing to them of like, oh, wow, I can do this. And this enables me to do this. So that's what we're diving into. Now, no doubt, if you're running ads for clients, you know standard events. Okay, that's that standard event code that gets put onto a page, or perhaps on some pages like Kajabi, for example, it's already plugged in and firing for you. So when somebody opts in for a free guide or a checklist, the lead standard event code will fire. If someone opts in for a webinar, then perhaps you've got the complete registration code firing. If someone's booked a call, then perhaps you've got the scheduled standard event code firing. The thing is, it doesn't really matter which event you use where. Like, I know of some clients who have had the lead standard event firing when someone opts in for a guide or cheat sheet, and that's where I typically would use it as well. However, I do know others that have fired the lead standard event when people have booked a call, right? That's their lead. And so that's the event that they're firing for, which is absolutely fine. But as you can see, that's two very different people. Someone who's just opting in for a guide that might cost, you know, $3, $5, $10 per lead, versus someone who's booked in for a discovery call, which might be $150, $200, $250 for a booked call. Very different person that you would be targeting there, or who you would be optimizing for. The key with your standard events, or any of those events where you're tracking conversions, is to keep it consistent. So if the lead event is firing for people who have booked calls, awesome. That's what that lead event is for. If you've been using the lead event for people who have opted in for the guide, great, continue to use it there. Maybe you've used it for webinar registrations, that's fine as well. Just keep it consistent. So with our standard events, that's just the event that comes from Facebook, right? We have lead, we have complete registration, we've got contact even, we've got scheduled, we've got application submitted. There's a number, purchase, of course, purchase standard event, initiate checkout, add to cart. We've got that list of standard events from Facebook. So some sites, like I mentioned, Kajabi, for example, it will have them included if you've built a funnel or a pipeline with their software, and it will fire a lead or a purchase, whatever it is. Okay. Otherwise, you need to get the standard event code over onto that confirmation page. So if they've purchased, that purchase confirmation page, we will have the purchase standard event code. They've opted in for a guide, then on that confirmation page, we will have the lead standard event firing. So that's our standard events. Pretty standard. There's not much else you can do with them. They're just standard events. Now, a custom event is where you customize a standard event. So that is where you can put your own label into the script so that it's custom. Where this is handy is if, for example, you've got a client, they're running three different lead magnet funnels. Okay, lead magnet one, lead magnet two, and lead magnet three. And so if you just have the lead standard event installed on each one of those thank you pages, then lead event's going to be firing, which is great, but there could be some cross funnel attribution going on, which means they may have last seen the ad for lead magnet A1, I think I called it, but then they've ended up opting in through lead magnet number three and fired the lead event. So in Facebook's eyes, the last ad they saw was for lead magnet one, but they've converted on lead magnet three. They've still fired a lead standard event. So the lead magnet one ad is going to get the attribution. Whereas if you have custom events installed, I would still include the standard event. The standard event is on their firing lead, perfect, and that's what you would optimize for. But for your tracking purposes, as much as we can track it on Facebook these days, having the custom event will help you to see which funnel has brought in that lead. So for custom events, I would still use the lead standard event, but then you might say lead magnet A. So it would be lead underscore lead magnet A or something LM for nice and short, LM1, I'll keep it with the numbers. Then on the second lead magnet funnel, on the confirmation page, you'll have the lead standard event again, and then you'll have a custom event, which is just a variation of the standard event that would be lead underscore LM2 for lead magnet 2. And then the same with lead magnet 3. Lead standard event, and then a custom event that would be lead underscore LM3. That way, you can track on those thank you pages if LM3, lead LM3 has fired, or if it's lead LM1. Now, when you create your custom events though, as soon as it's created, you need to fire the page, or you've installed it on the page, you need to fire the page so that the pixel fires and gets sent back to Facebook, okay? You'll be able to see it over there in Events Manager that it is firing. But what you then need to do is to create a custom conversion for that custom event. I know that all sounds a bit confusing, but you've created the custom event. Now we need to say to Facebook, pull this in so that I can see it in my Ads Manager reporting, or even you could optimize for it then. So you create a conversion based off the event. Normally when people create custom conversions, it's based off a URL, but when you go to create it, you'll see events there. And once you've fired those events that you've, those custom events that you've just installed, like lead underscore LM1, lead underscore LM2, lead underscore LM3, they would have fired in Events Manager. And you know, you might need to leave it about 20 or 30 minutes for it to come through, but you'll see them in the events. So you would be able to select that event as this custom conversion. Okay, so that way in your Ads Manager reporting, when you customize your columns, you'll be able to see columns for lead LM1, lead LM2, and lead LM3, those custom events that you've created. So that way, when you're looking at your Ads Manager reporting, you can pull in those three additional columns, and you may see that your lead magnet one campaign has attributed a lead, but then when you look across at those three columns for lead magnet 1, 2, and 3, you may see that lead event actually fired on lead magnet 3, okay? So that's where custom events are so valuable to include with your ads for tracking purposes. Not, I don't use them so much for optimizing. I use standard events for optimizing and in my aggregated events, but I will use custom events to be able to pull in the columns and the reporting so I can see the actual funnel and see how things are converting across the funnel. Okay, and to avoid the cross-funnel attribution confusion that can sometimes happen. So that's our custom events. Whew, there was a lot of information in those. Now we're going to circle back to custom conversions. So just like I mentioned, you can create a custom conversion based on your custom event. What most people use to create their custom conversions from is a URL. Now, typically we'll do this if we can't access the back end and install the standard event code or the custom event code. Okay, some people just default to using this, which is fine. I don't. I prefer standard events and I prefer custom events. Custom events, especially, and standard events are more robust. So for example, if the URL changes, if you need to put it on a different URL, you can install that custom event code on a different URL and it will still track that same custom event. Whereas if you created a customer conversion and the URL has changed, then you need to recreate the custom conversion again. So with our custom conversions, how people normally create them would be based on a URL. Now, when you do that, you need to make sure that you select URL contains. Don't do it with URL equals, because so often the URL will change. For example, with Facebook ads, if you've ever noticed, you click on a Facebook ad, you go over to a URL that at the end of the URL at the .com, it might say, .com/guide, then there'll be a question mark and it'll be FB click, okay? So the URL often will change. You'll have dynamically adding URLs, you'll have UTM parameters that'll be going in there. So super important that when you're creating one, you just select contains and you use just the minimum. I never include HTTP, HTTPS. I will just start it at the start of the domain. So like jodymillwood.com/TY guide would be the guide thank you page. And that's just what I would say, it contains that. Okay, and so that is the custom conversion. And like I mentioned, custom conversions can be created from the URLs, or they can also be created from events. So any custom events that you create. And you can optimize your ads for custom conversions as well. But like I said, I prefer to use standard events, okay, and customize for standard events, or sorry, optimize for standard events, because that way I can get as much information as I can on that standard event and get as much data on the pixel for that event versus if I were to have a custom conversion for lead magnet one, custom conversion for lead magnet two, and a custom conversion for lead magnet three, that's spreading out information on three different sort of pixel events. Whereas if I just use lead, and that's what I optimize for, lead is getting all that great information so it knows to optimize, you know, it has more data to optimize for lead events versus them being spread out on different custom conversions. So that's how I like to do it. I like to use standard events. I like to use custom events that I create a custom conversion from then, just so I can see what's happening in Ads Manager and avoid any cross-funnel attribution. And then there's also custom conversions, which you may have to use at times if you can't access the back end to install the standard event codes. So what is your conversion event pixel of choice? Standard events, custom conversions, or custom events? I'd love to know. Send me an email at success@socialcharlie.com. Let me know which event you use or comment below. I'll keep an eye out for that and I'd love to hear what's working for you and what your preference is. That's it for this episode. I look forward to talking to you next time. Bye for now.